Mr. Erdogan spoke to Russian despot Vladimir Putin today about the crisis and the pair vowed to stay in close contact. It comes a day after the Turkish leader talked to Donald Trump, who tweeted that missiles are coming to Bashar al-Assad's brutal Moscow-supported regime. Speaking in Ankara, Mr. Erdogan said Turkey would maintain its presence and activities in Syria until the country became safe for everyone. The White House said yesterday Mr. Trump had spoken to the Turkish leader about his concerns and they had agreed to stay in close contact. Giddy Vladimir Putin and Recep Erdogan will talk Syria. Mr. Erdogan has been outspoken to both nations about the Syrian conflict, calling for civilian deaths to end and urging the U.S. to clarify its future role in the country. Mr. Trump confused the situation on social media again this morning, a day after he threw the world into panic by telling the Russians missiles were coming to Syria. He tweeted today, "Never said when an attack on Syria would take place. Could be very soon or not so soon at all. In any event, the United States, under my administration, has done a great job of ridding the region of ISIS. Where is our thank you, America?" His latest intervention comes as Theresa May convened her war cabinet to discuss joining U.S.-led action against Syria following a poison gas attack that killed at least 70 people. Mrs. May is thought to be preparing to authorize UK forces to strike against Assad without seeking a vote in Parliament. It comes amid reports that Royal Navy submarines had been ordered into range to launch Tomahawk cruise missile strikes as early as Thursday night. Speaking during a visit to Birmingham on Wednesday, Mrs. May sidestepped questions as to whether she was prepared to give MPs a vote. She said that she would continue to work with Britain's closest allies, the US and France, to ensure that those responsible for the barbaric attack were held to account. "We have been working to get an understanding of what happened on the ground. We are rapidly reaching that understanding," she said. "All the indications are that the Syrian regime was responsible, and we will be working with our closest allies on how we can ensure that those who are responsible are held to account." The continued use of chemical weapons cannot go unchallenged.